up, here it comes. Right there, the flying jalapeno. Caught him right in the jaw.
Tito Santana looking good as always, especially in Madison Square Garden. I know, Brain, you're going to start pushing me now for more information on our Ultimate Challenge special.
Well, you know, you gave the date to the humanoids, but you never
March
told us.
March 25th, yes.
You never told them what time.
Special airtime for that particular date, March 25th, on a Sunday night, is 7 to 9 p.m. Eastern Standard Time.
Oh, that'll be great. So the little children can watch it and still get in time to get to bed. And once your parents go to sleep, they can
that way.
Sneak out and hit their
you
wallets.
You think everybody here at the USA Network and Primetime Wrestling is as unintelligent as you are?
Well, these are very intelligent people at USA and at World Wrestling Federation. That's why they have me.
We already gave you one match. We're about to give you another one right now. That is the Red Rooster, who you won't like, Brain, because now he's up there getting these hot matches now that he's left the Heenan family. Opposition for him will be the Million Dollar Man.
You think he'll fit in this bank?
Right here on March 25th on Primetime Wrestling. We'll be back. To the hospital of late, and I think he's not worried too much about Mark Ming this week here on Primetime Wrestling, but you can bet your bottom dollar, Brain, he'll be worried about Hercules come April 1.
You know, when I look at the earthquake walk down that aisle, when he gets in the ring and I look into his eyes, I don't think he's worried about anybody.
Walk down the aisle?
Yes.
It's like the guy's getting married or something.
No, I mean, when he leaves the dressing room area and comes to the ring, I watch their face. I watch their expression. See, I study
this.
Let's go
to ringside.
The following contest is scheduled for one fall.
Alfred, have you had dinner yet?
The ring.
That's not my tummy.
Oh, it's not your tummy rumbling.
That's the ground shaking.
Oh, it is. My goodness.
Here is.
And here he comes. From a bottom up.
And
wow.
And his opponent, weighing at 240 pounds. And
everything is shaking and trembling here.
Here is Mark Ming.
Mark Ming with a very cautious look on his face, and rightfully so, as the earthquake rumbles into the ring along with Colonel Jimmy Hart. And immediately he gets all geared up for Mark Ming.
How would you like going up against this guy?
Uh-huh. The agility of this huge man is quite astonishing. And the speed, you saw the way he ran across the ring there, those two journeys across the ring at great speed.
Sending Ming in, missing the clothesline, but did not miss that time. And I'm sure he does not want to miss when it comes to WrestleMania 6 as Earthquake has a match signed with the mighty Hercules. And I think that is going to be quite a test for Earthquake, because we know Hercules can take... Oh, look at this, a dropkick.
Oh, oh, my word. That was a great dropkick.
It really was, showing his agility. Earthquake is the type of guy that believes that the power of Hercules is no match for him in WrestleMania 6.
Hercules, look at me! The earthquake in the ring! Look at my power! Look at my meanness! Hercules, you can't take me in WrestleMania! Nobody can survive the earthquake!
I think he's right about that, including Mark Ming, and he's about ready to feel it, Alfred. Watch out.
I think he's dead right about that.
Here we go. Ming is down. Continue. Let's get the official word.
Here is your winner.
Oh, no.
Earthquake.
Not again. The Earthquake one more time on Mark Ming.
Well, that's not right. They shouldn't allow that. Something should be done about this. I don't know what they could do to stop him, though.
Oh, no.
Who could stop the Earthquake?
Maybe it can be Hercules. And again.
Oh, my word. Let us see exactly how he achieved that victory, although we don't need too much of a reminder. A tremendous dropkick. That was earlier. And here, look, with a power slam that really finished him off there. But he comes in with a shattering earthquake. Ah! And that is damaging to him. Well, there you see the extent of the damage.
You're right about the extent of the damage. A very injured Mark Ming at the hands of Earthquake. What's in store for Hercules in WrestleMania 6? We'll find out.
I think it's wrong.
My opinion.
Guy sticking his nose in where it don't belong.
Well, you tell the Earthquake.
Hulkster gave him a negative attitude, didn't he?
Well, see, Hogan's not a smart guy.
No, no.
Hogan's trying to save Warrior for himself. They have something to settle, the Ultimate Challenge. But if Hogan was smart, he'd let the Earthquake squash the Warrior like a grape. Now, he'd be injured.
That's possible.
Now, the Warrior would still have to get in the ring at WrestleMania 6, April 1st. He'd be all busted up. Be easy pickings like that.
Do you think for one moment that the World Wrestling Federation champion Hulk Hogan would want a victory over someone who's less than 100%?
No, I don't. That's why he's not smart. Take it whenever you can. The guy's missing a limb. Take it. The guy's back's out. If his neck's broke, take it. It's a win. You get your hand raised. Take it. Take that money, put it in that wallet, zoom to the bank, give it to the teller, gives you the receipt.
Sounds just like Jesse the Body. You're two of a kind. Can't believe it. Special interview headed our way right now. Let's go to Mean Gene.
Cash.
He does my hair. Here comes Brutus the Barber. Beefcake. Oh, yeah.
So he doesn't mean he's there, huh?
He doesn't have much work to do, does he?
WrestleMania right around the corner, and in that big spectacular, you're going to be facing none other than Mr. Perfect.
Well, I am so happy, Mean Gene, to have this opportunity to take on Mr. Perfect in WrestleMania 6, brother, because I am pumped up and I am ready as I've ever been, Mean Gene, to get in WrestleMania and give somebody a haircut that they will never forget.
You know, Brutus, speaking of haircuts, recently in front of a national television audience, I've got to say this, you gave his advisor, Mr. Perfect's advisor, the genius, the old flat top, that special cut.
Well, Gene, I didn't quite get finished with that haircut because a little interference, Mr. Perfect jumping on my back, sticking his nose where it didn't belong. Well, that's okay because you didn't bust me up quite enough there, Perfect. You didn't get the job done. That's your biggest mistake, because now I'm coming right for you in WrestleMania 6. I've been in 5 WrestleManias, Perfect. I know what it's all about to step in there. And believe me, there will be no butterflies.
You know, I should point out one thing here in closing. Brutus the Barber Beefcake, on many an occasion, the genius is in the corner, and he has been known to interfere.
Well, Mean Gene, I got a little plan, something I worked out especially for the genius, to take care of any and all outside interference. So I hope you come down, genius. I hope you're waiting at ringside. I hope you step in there, brother. Because I'm going to take care of you. And when I take care of Mr. Perfect, I might have both of them laying side by side. I might have to go eeny, meeny, miny, hey, mo. You know, I just go crazy sometimes, BG. I might have to cut everybody in the building. You never know.
All right, Brutus the Barber Beefcake, Mr. Perfect in WrestleMania. Any final comments?
Well, Mr. Perfect, just to end a perfect night, I won't be able to do anything but give you the perfect haircut. Yeah!
He's been cutting and shredding during WrestleMania 6. You better believe that.
Obviously not satisfied. Wants to get the job done, and done in yellow this time, or golden perhaps.
I've had it up to here with Beefcake. Do you think Beefcake is really going to cut Perfect's hair?
It's possible.
This man is perfect.
It's possible.
He's a perfect record.
And he could get a perfect haircut.
This buffoon with some used pair of clippers.
Let's just take a look at him, folks. He definitely does not have a perfect haircut. Agree or don't agree?
He has a perfect haircut. Agree or don't agree?
We'll be back.
Yeah.